Hello friends. In this video, we will review a recently released compact Zigbee relay from the well-known manufacturer of smart devices for the Tuya Smart ecosystem, Moes. This device expands the Star Ring relay lineup for junction boxes, which includes both Wi-Fi and Zigbee models. Until now, the energy monitoring feature was only available in the Wi-Fi version. With the release of this relay, energy monitoring is now available for Zigbee as well. At the time of testing, the relay had just been launched on the market, so there are some minor issues with its support. I am confident these will be resolved over time. Meanwhile, we have an opportunity to practice creating an external converter for zigbee2mqtt, partly using the internal generator and partly adding functionality manually. Details are provided below, but for now, I kindly ask you to like this video so that more people interested in smart home topics can find it. Also, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Type of device: relay for junction boxes. Manufacturer: Moes. Model: ZM-104-M-16AM. Interface: Zigbee 3.0. Functions: energy monitoring, state memory, external mechanical switch. Operating voltage: 90 to 250 volts. Maximum current: 16 amperes. Operating temperature range: -10 degrees Celsius to 65 degrees Celsius. Dimensions: 40 by 40 by 18 millimeters. Control applications: Moes, Tuya Smart, Smart Life. The device comes in a small cardboard box. Unlike many other Tuya gadgets that arrive in plain packaging, this one includes the manufacturer's logo, a photo, the model number, and basic specifications. Inside, there is a relay secured in a cardboard holder to keep it in place, along with a rather extensive manual. The manual is available in 8 languages: English, with the most detailed description and brief descriptions in Spanish, Italian, Portuguese, Russian, German, French, and Polish. The relay is quite budget-friendly. At the start of sales, special discounts were available, and one of the two units used in this review cost me less than $3. The relay is very compact, smaller than most of its counterparts. It can be installed both in a junction box and on a DIN rail, for which a special detachable frame is included in the package. Underneath the frame, on the back of the device, is a reset button. Interestingly, I didn't need to use it during testing, as the relay automatically switches to pairing mode upon first power-up or removal from the hub. A screw terminal with 6 contacts is used for connection. It includes an incoming neutral wire, 2 contacts each for incoming and outgoing phases, and an external switch. Several size comparisons: here it is next to a regular matchbox. This is one of its functional counterparts, a Zigbee relay with energy monitoring from Matsi. You can find a review of it via the link in the description. Its compact size allows it to be easily installed in a standard round junction box, behind a switch or outlet. The relay is generally easy to disassemble, and this one is no exception. The two halves of the case are held together by a pair of latches. All components are neatly installed, and the soldering looks high quality. Electrolytic capacitors, 470F at 10V, are used for smoothing out ripples and stabilizing voltage. The relay installed is the SAF Set 705LM, designed to handle loads up to 16A at 250V AC or 30V DC. The Q1 power transistor can be used to control the relay or protect the circuits from overload. This is the control module, ZT2S. It has certification markings for use in EU countries and compliance with European safety standards. 3 robust contacts on the top are intended for connecting phase and neutral wires, as well as the output to the load. They appear substantial enough to meet the power management requirements. Time to proceed with testing, which requires assembling a test setup. I connect power to the relay, neutral to the in contact, and phase to the L contact. The relay will work even if the contacts are swapped. However, breaking the neutral line poses a risk of electric shock if you are working, for example, to replace a connected load. The relay supports control via an external mechanical switch. Let's connect one as well. To do this, the second L contact, incoming phase, is used, which, through the switch, will connect to the S1 contact. To connect a load, I will use a regular outlet. The neutral line contact is connected directly to the electrical network's neutral, while the phase is connected to one of the L1 contacts. In my case, The second contact is unused and can be used for a parallel connected load. As I mentioned earlier, the relay automatically switches to pairing mode after its first power on or removal from the hub. If you need to reset it manually, this can be done by holding down the button on the case or toggling the external switch 10 times. This is convenient if the relay is in a junction box behind the switch. Instead of an LED indicator, which would not be visible, a buzzer is used. Let's start with the basic control system, Tuya Smart. Technically speaking, the base system is Moes, which is a Tuya clone. To connect the relay, you'll need a Zigbee hub. In my case, it's the wired version with HomeKit support. When pairing the relay and hub, the buzzing naturally stops. At the time of testing, the review model was identified this way, with a template image and name. The device plugin is quite simple and also uses a template. In the center of the main screen is a button to toggle the relay on and off. To access the energy monitoring panel, click the electricity button at the bottom of the page. The relay's clicking noise is audible but not loud. Inside a junction box, it will be even quieter. The switch works in parallel with the app. Each toggle changes the relay's state. The status updates quickly, with no noticeable delays. Here is the first issue I mentioned earlier. Energy monitoring data does not update. I tested two relay units on two different hubs. However, the functionality exists, as I will demonstrate later in the video. This is a software glitch. The timer menu offers five task options. Countdown sets a time after which the relay changes its state to the opposite. Scheduled on off times lets you specify times and days for the relay to turn on or off, either once or periodically. Circulation allows setting time periods based on days of the week during which the relay will toggle on and off for the specified durations. Random enables random on off toggling within specified time periods, for example, to create the illusion of someone being home. Inching requires specifying a time interval in seconds. After activating the mode, the relay will automatically turn off after this interval following activation. An example of the inching mode with a 5-second interval. The device settings menu includes options for relay behavior after power restoration. Always on, always off, or remember the last state. All modes work. Switch settings include two modes for standard switches. Each toggle changes the state or synchronization, and one mode for doorbell-style switches. At the time of testing, changes were not possible, and the default setting was that each toggle changes the state. The general settings menu is standard. It includes compatibility with third-party systems, offline notifications, sharing access, firmware updates, the latest version was pre-installed, and system removal. Automations, section if, triggers. There are 7 event options available, but currently, you can only rely on state changes, on or off. Countdown might also work, but it doesn't have many practical applications. The other options are tied to energy monitoring. Events have even been found for triggering protections. Additionally, standard options include voltage being above, equal to, or below a set value. The same applies to power and current, with current measured in milliamperes. There is also a condition that triggers when power increases by a specified value from the current level. For actions, things are simpler. You can turn the relay on, off, toggle its state, or set a countdown timer for state changes. Let's check compatibility with Google Home. The relay is still connected to the Tuya hub. Interaction occurs at the account level, which is linked to Google Home and automatically transfers data about all compatible devices. The relay appeared in the list. Only on off control is available, including via the voice assistant. Tuya created automations may also work. The hub I am using is integrated into Home Assistant via the HomeKit protocol. Similarly, everything will work with the Apple Home app, as the same protocol is used. The relay appeared here as a switch. There is no energy monitoring, but I wasn't expecting it. Toggling works without noticeable delays. Unlike Google Home, interaction here is local. Next, let's test the native integration of Tuya devices into Home Assistant. I should note that everything I've shown, including this, works simultaneously. All available objects from the Tuya plugin were transferred here. This includes the switch, behavior after power restoration, and energy monitoring sensors, which are hidden by default. To make them visible, we expand the list. Sensors for current, power, and voltage were found. We click on each one. In the window that opens, we go to the object settings. Here, we enable it. This process is repeated for each object. After some time, the enabled sensors will appear in the system. In this case, it's not particularly useful since energy monitoring in Tuya isn't functioning yet. However, once it's fixed, they could be helpful. Now it's time to disconnect the relay from the hub. It automatically switches to pairing mode and starts beeping, allowing us to test it with alternative coordinators. First up is the Sonoff iHost, firmware version 2.3.4 as of the test date. I initiate the connection mode, and the relay is detected and identified, judging by the image, as one of Tuya's wall switches. The R symbol in the top right corner of the relay's tile indicates that it acts as a router in the Zigbee network. Here's what's available on off switching and several options for setting delayed tasks. Schedule allows you to plan the relays on a off operations at specific times and on selected days of the week. Delay, similar to a countdown. You set a time and the state the relay will adopt. A cyclic timer lets you schedule periodic on off operations. The settings menu allows you to configure the relay's behavior after power restoration. There is also information about signal quality, device ID, model, and manufacturer. Returning to Home Assistant, this time using alternative coordinators. This is the native ZHA integration for working with Zigbee devices, using a USB Zigbee stick based on the EFR32MG21 module with SkyConnect firmware. I enabled the mode for connecting new devices and removed the relay from iHost. It automatically activated pairing and connected to ZHA. Here, relay toggling and energy monitoring sensors are available. Interestingly, voltage readings are already displayed, which is a good sign. I turn the relay on and observe that energy monitoring is functioning, showing both power and current. This confirms that everything is working fine at the relay level. The lack of data in Tuya is a software issue, which I hope will be resolved soon. Control over the status indicator is also available here, but since the relay lacks an actual indicator, this option is redundant. Setting the behavior after power restoration works correctly. I tested it. In ZHA, the relay is fully operational. For a complete picture, let's evaluate the speed of energy monitoring sensor updates. Everything is quite fast, and the parameters are accurate. Traditionally, in the final part of the review, we move to Zigbee 2MQTT. The current version at the time of testing was 1.41.0. Connecting the relay, it's detected and added to the system, but I haven't created any converters yet. Let's take a closer look. Remember how the relay appeared in iHost? It looks exactly the same in Zigbee 2MQTT on the specified version. I assume that full native support will be added later. As a result, only a limited set of objects is available. State control and behavior after power restoration. The system recognizes it as a switch, which might be due to the manufacturer's similar code. In the case of ZHA, clusters are analyzed instead of the ID, which is why it worked right away there. Opening the last tab on the device page, the developer console, there's a button here for generating an external converter. Here's the auto-generated code, which I'll test first. For many standard devices, this is sufficient. In the add-ons folder, by default, located in the Home Assistant directory under the Zigbee 2MQTT folder, I create a new file named after the manufacturer's ID with a.js extension. I copy the converter code into it and save. Next, I copy the file name and return to the Zigbee 2MQTT interface. Here, in the Settings menu, we go to the External Converters section. Click the plus symbol to add a new empty row. Paste the converter file name into the row and click the Submit button. After this, a Reload add-on button will appear. After reloading, the Exposures page looks like this. The appearance of energy monitoring sensors and voltage values is promising. However, not everything is perfect yet. Energy monitoring data only updates with manual refreshes or by restarting the relay's power supply. Here, I updated the power data, but current remains stuck at zero. Another issue, there's no setting for behavior after power restoration or specifying the switch type. Let's tweak the converter. First, I add a standard block with library references for Tuya devices. I'll note that this block is slightly redundant for this converter, but a few extra lines won't hurt. In this block, I made cosmetic changes and specified the correct name for the relay. This block handles the automatic updating of energy monitoring data. The first line adds a field for setting the update interval, and the second line implements the updates. This block specifies the switch type and behavior after power restoration. After modifying, restart zigbee2mqtt. Here's how the exposures page looks with the updated converter. Switch settings and behavior options have appeared. Let's test energy monitoring. First, on the specific settings page for this device, set the update interval to 5 seconds. Now the sensors update automatically. However, another nuance emerged. Current data is transmitted in milliamperes, which would translate to 0.3 amperes in this case, similar to what ZHA displayed. In the converter, a divisor can be added, but identifying the data point ID involves some challenges. While considering this, another thought occurred. Why not keep the data in milliamperes? For small loads, the data's precision will be higher. For instance, in ZHA, it showed 0.3 instead of 0.312. If needed, a template sensor with any conversion can be created. So I decided to leave it as is. Here's the energy monitoring speed in real time. Note that it can be manually adjusted. The code for the shown converter is linked in the description. Another Zigbee relay with energy monitoring joins the long line of similar devices for the Tuya Smart ecosystem. It impressed with its compact size, good build quality, and support in alternative systems. The downsides, for now, are software issues, particularly non-functional energy monitoring in Tuya Smart and incomplete native support in zigbee2mqtt, which can be easily addressed with a converter. That's all for now. I hope this video was helpful and interesting. Your likes would be greatly appreciated. They help with visibility on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new tutorials and reviews, subscribe to my channel. The description contains all the necessary links to shops where you can buy the device, the converter code file, other videos on this topic, my Telegram channels, my Facebook page, and a group for discussing smart home questions. Join us, it'll be interesting. Thank you for your attention. See you next time, and peace to all.